Hello, I am Dr. Bablu Biswas from PN Das College. Today we learn the concept of cyclic group or homogeneous group. Perhaps you have heard the name of Augustin Louis Cauchy. He was a great French mathematician. In his life, he published more than 800 papers in different topics of mathematics. And he is also responsible for cyclic notion in algebra. Before going to the definition, I will give you an example. Consider the group Z plus, means set of all integers with respect to the operation addition. And we will show you that a single element can generate all the elements of this group. If you take any positive integer, let n be a positive integer, then n can be written as 1 plus 1 plus 1 n times. So it is generated by 1. If n be a negative integer, then n equal to minus m, where m is some positive integer, then we also can write n equal to minus m equal to minus of 1 plus 1 plus 1. This is m times. And if n equal to 0, we can write n equal to 0 times 1. So we can write z equal to n into 1, where n is an integer. Okay. So, Z is generated by 1. So, this is the concept of a cyclic group. If a group is generated by a single element, then that group is called a cyclic group. Okay? Now, we come to the definition. A group G composition is said to be a cyclic group if there exists an element A in G such that G is generated by A. The notation is used to mean that all the elements of A can be generated by A. A is called the generator of the group G. So G can be written like this: A to the power n. N is an integer for multiplicative group, and also G can be written like this way, where G is an additive group. Okay. Now, one thing we should write, where AN means A composition, A composition A n times. Okay. Now I will give you an example. I have started with an example. So Z plus is a cyclic group. Example, Z plus is a cyclic group. Number two, you know Zn plus is a group, and this is also a cyclic group because Zn is generated by class 1. Okay. Number 3, there is another example. If we take, let G be the collection of cube roots of 1. That means element, if X belongs to G, then this will be like that X, and this will give X cube equal to 1, or x cube minus 1 equal to 0, that is x minus 1, x square plus x plus 1 equal to 0. This will give you x equal to 1, and this part will give you minus 1 plus minus root over 3 into I by 2. And we can express this at x equal to 1, 1 is omega and other one is omega square. If we take G equal to 1 omega omega square, then this group will be a cyclic group with respect to multiplication. We can show you very easily. You see, G equal to 1 omega omega square. Here, there are some properties, omega cube equal to 1. Now, if we take omega to the power 1, this will give omega. Omega to the power 2 will give omega square. And omega cube will give you omega cube, that means equal to 1. So, we can write G is generated by omega. Also, there is another generator if we take omega square to the power 1, this will give you omega square. Omega square to the power 4 means omega cube into omega, that means omega, and omega square whole cube equal to omega cube square equal to 1. So all the elements of this group is generated by omega square. That means we can also write G equal to omega square. So omega and omega square are two generators. In fact, a cyclic group has two generators. The result if G is a cyclic group generated by A, then A inverse is also a generator of G. Okay, so a group has two generators. Now I will give you an example which is not cyclic. You see, we have Z plus is a cyclic group, but if we take R plus means set of all real numbers with respect to addition is not a cyclic group. Not a cyclic group. We can show it also. Let if possible, then R is generated by an element of R, then every element of R should be generated by A. A belong to R implies A by 2 belong to R. Then A by 2 should also be generated by A. So, then A by 2 should be like that, N into A. N is an integer. This gives N equal to half, which is a contradiction. So, there is no element in R which can generate all the elements of R. So, G is not a cyclic group. Okay. Now, I will mention you a very natural property of cyclic group. A cyclic group is commutative. You can prove it. This is very easy. You see, let G composition be a cyclic group. We have to show that this is a commutative group. So, we take two elements from G. Okay, and there should be a generator. We let A be the generator of this group. Then we can express x and y like that, a to the power n and y equal to a to the power m, where m and n are integers. Okay, now you see x composition y equal to a to the power n composition a to the power, but we are saying that this is equal to a to the power n plus m. On the contrary, if you take y composition x, then this is a to the power m composition a to the power n equal to a to the power m plus n equal to, and these two integers may commute, so this is a to the power n plus m. So, we have proved x composition y equal to with y composition x. X composition y equal to, and this is true for all the elements in G, obviously. So, G is a commutative group. So, we have proved a cyclic group is commutative. But the converse is not true. I will show you the matter. Just by an example, you see the converse is not true. The converse is not true. That is, a commutative group may not be cyclic. If we take Klein's four group, G composition, where G equal to E, A, B, C, then you know the composition table E, A, B, C, E, A, B, C. This should be E, A, B, C. A, E means A. This should be B. This should be C. Now, A equal to E. A, B equal to C. A, C equal to the third one, B. B, A equal to C. B, B equal to E. B, C equal to A. Again, C, A equal to B. C, B equal to A. And C, C equal to C. You see, the table is symmetric about its principal diagonal. So this group is a commutative group, but it is a commutative group. The question here is it cyclic? Let us see. We will take each element 1 by n. 1, E will generate only E. A will generate A and E because A square equal to E. B will generate B and E, and similarly C will generate C and E. So no element generates all the elements of this group. Therefore, we can claim that G is not a cyclic group. Okay. So a commutative group may not be a cyclic group. I will show you another interesting property for a finite cyclic group. Okay, if G be a finite cyclic group, with generator A and order G, then all the elements of G can be represented as G equal to E A square A to the power N by N minus 1. Sorry, order should be n. If the order of G is n, then all the elements of G will. Okay, there is another property that will help you to prove or to examine whether a group is cyclic or not. The property is like that: a group G is cyclic if there exists an element A in G such that order of A is equal to order of G. That's all till now, and we will discuss more about cyclic group in our next class. Thank you.